Hello everyone, Alan here, and I was all set up to do this Elemental Dignities VR, and I was gonna do it on my new laptop. This is my setup. It's balancing on a book. See underneath there? I have to balance it on a book and a box to make it even. There's my smiling face. But then I realized I couldn't add things to it because I don't know how to edit on my laptop yet. In fact, I don't even have Wi-Fi here on purpose. I used to have another computer on this desk to write on. I would write fiction on it. And in order to not be distracted, I could even get free Wi-Fi from across the street and I wouldn't get on it. And with this laptop, I can't receive that Wi-Fi for some reason. So I'm either going to have to buy Wi-Fi or lug this to the library, the laptop to edit. And that might work too, to put on my writer's hat and go up there or go to Starbucks. But on to the video. Hope everyone is journaling too. This is part of my tarot journal, and I will be using. I'm a very visual person, so I like to look at the symbols for the elements: water, fire, air, and earth. And I use the yin and yang, or you can use active and passive for the elements, and also male and female. Mars and Venus, active, passive, and male is yang energy, passive is yin energy. Water is yin, fire is yang, air is like intermediate. See how the lines go through the element symbols? That just makes it easier for me to know that air and fire get along. They're both, let's face it, it's pointed up like a flame, like a phallic symbol, like a pyramid. Water is pointing down. It's an upside down triangle. It's like womb-like, feminine-like. That's how I. Then you can correspond them with colors too. Blue for water, red for fire, yellow for air, green for earth, and north, south, east, and west as well. And then add on archangel names. Mikael, south, Gabriel, east, Oriel, north, green, and what last but not least, water is what? Gabriel. So now I wanted to get into the court cards because you can further do that, and I'm gonna put this on my tripod and come right back. Okay, now I've separated the court cards, and you can even do it by shades. There's two gray ones, four yellows, and 10 blues, and even the blues are in different shades. So sticking with the elements, name a court card. Let me just pick the Knight of Swords. So in the system of the Golden Dawn, the kings are fire, the queens are water, the knights are air, and the pentacles are earth. So, Knight of Swords would be air, actually. And we can see how windy this card is. Look at the trees in the background. This is the fastest of the knight. You can tell time and speed by the knights. Look at the horse's eye. He's looking back at the rider, going like WTF. He's going onward, ho. Okay, name a Let's see, pick another card. Knight of Cups. Stick with the Knights. He's a slower card. Knight, Air of Water. Cups are water. What do you get when you get air and water? Well, when you get water and air, you get rain. But air and water is more like humidity. Slow moving, laid back. Let's get a queen. Queen of Pentacles. Here we have, like, you want to say nature, right? The rabbit. Close to the empress. But she's water and earth. What do you get when you get water and earth? Literally. You get mud. Nature. Mud. Kind of maybe in a reading, muddying of waters. I'm just saying I'm picking out the elemental dignities, not in readings. And I'm linking, I started this off with Tom Benjamin's Oldie But Goodie. It's from 2012. And then Kelly and Truth in Story did a thorough video on this with links to. But I'll link to those two where, you lay out three cards at least. Well, at least two. But with, the core cards, you only need one. Page of Swords. Great example. Earth and Air. This is a creative card. Look at the luminesque up there. The birds make a figure eight. And they actually do in the Robin Wood deck. Remember that deck? But this is a card of creativity to me. Let's try a page of pentacles. Okay, pages are earth. Pentacles are earth. Earth and earth. Very earthy card outside. It's not a backdrop. It doesn't have the double lines down there, so going across. It's not one of Pixie's backdrop cards. This is someone looking into a mirror. Looking into themselves. Or could be someone looking into a crystal ball. So those are some examples of how I read elemental dignities. I hope you enjoyed watching this. If you do, I hope you subscribe or make a comment. I'd appreciate that. And I will see you online. Thank you.